A major threat in a major regional city is easing tonight, with the Murrumbidgee River now not expected to breach its peak. But the threat isn't over, with heavy weather expected on Wednesday. 10's Eddie Mai is at Wagga Wagga. And Eddie, just how bad is it expected to get?
Jackie, tomorrow is now expected to be a wait-and-see day. The SES does not expect the Murrumbidgee River to reach its peak of 10 metres tonight. It's sitting at about 9.65 metres and they expect that to hold, but they're most concerned about what's coming in the next few days. Now, a town meeting was held tonight. Some of the 1,000 residents who've been evacuated from their homes were given the warning about the weather on Wednesday, Thursday. Rainfall of between 80 and 140 millimetres. Now, to put that in perspective, at 80 millimetres, it's a once-in-20-year flood. At 140 millimetres, it's a once-in-50-year flood, at which point they would be gravely concerned. Everything within the levee bank that surrounds Wagga City should hold, should keep the city dry, but everything outside that levee would be affected. Now, if they weren't concerned before, they certainly were tonight. That's what's happening later in the week. And that's what everyone is now preparing for. Amanda Hart was out with residents today to see how they're coping.
This is what Wagga woke up to. The waterlogged landscape is tranquil, but a disaster zone.
It's on the rise and, yeah, it is a pretty impressive sight.
The Murrumbidgee lapping at the top of a levee in North Wagga, trying its best to break through. It had some luck seeping through a levee wall downtown. Three suburbs in Wagga are now completely cut off. It was enough to prompt New South Wales Premier Christina Keneally to declare the region a disaster zone.
But it is humbling to see the devastating impact that nature can have on a community.
It means residents affected by the floods can access emergency funds. The SES and the Army doing everything they can to keep the city dry.
As I said, we've used 150,000 sandbags so far, and more are being deployed right across the state.
But those sandbags can be little use against a fierce flow. Some businesses are barely breathing.
Yeah, it's just hard to say like what we're going to end up with when it's all gone. Obviously a huge mess.
And patios have sunk. At 1 o'clock, no homes had major inundation. Some properties on the outskirts of town did have water lapping at their front doors. And depending on the weather over the next couple of days, some properties could be isolated until the end of the week. And for some, the only way to get around is by boat. But others are being urged to stay out of boats after the SES performed a canoe rescue this morning. But like this little mouse here, others are just trying to keep their chin up.
Maybe if the water comes up, I think he'll save me.
Amanda Hart, 10 News.